The big question is, how did the debate go over with voters, particularly the undecideds that both candidates are working so hard to sway? NBC's Ron Allen watched with a group of them in the battleground state of Colorado.
A healthcare system that is broken, energy policies that are not working.
Wayne Gerber, a Democrat, arrived leaning toward Obama. His wife, Kim Buchholz, a Republican, was leaning toward McCain. Then something strange happened after the candidates went head to head.
So for you, McCain did better, and for you, Obama did better.
Yeah, we switched.
But that's the whole...
You switched.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I thought he was very eloquent, very, very confident, very strong. I thought McCain was a little shaky tonight.
McCain said numerous times, Obama is naive, he doesn't get it.
And I think he's right.
McCain's grasp of national security impressed them all. Sal Steels voted for Obama in the primary, but now leans toward McCain.
Literally, you're talking about somebody who has boots on the ground. I mean, a guy that's like, I've been there.
However, everyone said domestic issues concern them more. That seemed to help Obama, with Kelsey Guyette, a college freshman Republican, about to cast her first vote for president.
I think that they kind of gave, or at least Obama, I felt, gave a specific plan. He's like, one, two, three, this is what I'm going to do.
So you're going to vote for Obama?
I don't know.
Lisa Flick liked what McCain said about small business and low taxes. A Republican and self-styled Reagan Democrat who likes McCain's long resume. But
do I think that one of my most important stance, in which is the military, that Senator McCain is much more knowledgeable? Absolutely. But Senator Obama talks to me about change without saying a word.
Overall, they were disappointed and confused by the answers about the financial crisis. They wanted more give and take and specifics.
They wouldn't challenge each other and say, I think you're wrong on this.
Susan Jacobson, an independent who voted for Bush and then Kerry, saw no clear choice.
They both have really strong, good ideas about vastly different things.
They all expressed relief to finally see a thoughtful, serious debate instead of all the negative ads. The night gave James Wilde, an independent, more hope.
I'm still undecided, but I have a lot less animosity toward both of them.
That's good.
Seriously.